take a look, see where the problem spots are. Usually in pieces like this, it's if you have a rest. And then we run into problems. How long do I rest? Did I miss that? Where was I? Because the piano's really no help when we're doing it this way. So, then said the shepherds, one more time, top of the page. One, two,
three, four, sing the shepherds.
Oh.
I don't want cold and, you know, little namby-pamby boy voices, but that kind of British merry, especially when we go fast, is not going to have time to go merry, flip the arms, merry. All right, back to the beginning, just the first 8 measures or so. One, two, three, four. And then it's winded, which doesn't make sense because to me you blow wind through a bugle, so it's winded, but we'll make it rhyme with the mind and it's winded.
They had a crank on.
Well, yeah.
Wind up that bugle there.
No, it's just that it's not Diana and Rihanna. It's either Ori and Diana.
Yeah, so we'll go with some rhyming bits. So can I hear just the soprano, two, and tenor at measure 9, the shepherds. That's actually pick up the 10 there. Just the second sopranos and tenors. 1, 2, 3.
Three.
And
Calvin on birds.
Quite a bit.
In history, yes.
Ladies, will you look with me? We'll decide this for sure once we have everybody here. But look at the last four measures. Figure out which part you want. It divides into six, and so I only need a couple of voices on that top. We're just going to go ahead and read this through. Some people know this because we've been doing this for a while. Fair warning, bottom of page four, there's a random 5-4 measure. So just so you're aware, that's in there. Good. We're just going to read it through. Sopranos and basses are taking turns. Or sopranos and baritones, I guess.
I could see that show.
Are taking turns, although we could use all this.
I'm really proud of my church voice that's finally turned to development 26. Congratulations,
all right, here we go. From the beginning.
I get a lot. Okay.
Good. Thank you.
Oh,
West Side Story is one of my favorites, I will admit. And I fell in love with this arrangement when it came out. Just, it captures for me that kind of etherealness of this. You know, when they're somewhere there's going to be a time. And there are parts where we're all together, but a lot of this is kind of, you know, everybody's kind of doing their own thing, or the men are doing one thing and the ladies are doing something else. It's very ethereal, and it captures that for me. And then we get that nice, strong final page when we get there. So, love it. Let's go to square A. This is the bottom of page 3. Let's work section A there.
All the ones we haven't done.
Right there. Here we are. Next.
Okay.
from square A. Let's try it there at square A, bottom of page 3. Think good long open vowels, there are. Here we are, and.
Thank you.
It's marked just baritones there at measure nine, but any basses that want to sing lightly up there, we welcome you to join us if it's possible. So, good, one more time just on loop, getting familiar with the tune there, and it feels one and two. Change from the madrigal where everything's, you know, or somewhere where everything's going different places, although that had spots where it would line up. So this is homophonic music. Ian asked me about my very strange algebra. This very strange algebra is actually a German 101 tutorial. A very small part of it. If you see a W, you sing a V. W's equal V's. V's equal F's.
And F's equal.
Yeah. If you see an IE or an EI, you sing the second one. So if it's IE, you sing E.
The long
if it's EI, you sing I.
Der Esel nennt sich immer zuerst.
Yes, right.
Whatever.
So that means you just sing the second one, whatever it is, that's what you sing. And if you have an ST, you sing I had to be very careful when I wrote that. Nobody had anything. Yeah, there are other things that will change, but that's the brief version. So, Gregor, I'm going to have Gregor stand and read the words to this slowly, and just kind of listen, make notes as you need to.
In stiller back.
Stiller back.
Yeah.
Sorry. In stiller, I'm singing Latin. In stiller Nacht zur ersten Wacht ein Stimm begunnt zu klagen. Der nächtige Wind hat süß und lind zu mir den Klang getragen. Von erbem Leid und Traurigkeit ist mir das Herz zerflossen. Die Blümelein mit Tränen rein, sorry, I'm being Swiss, hab ich sie all big ghost. And
so that's all we're going to do right now is the first verse. Will you read it one more time so everybody can
repeat after me. In stille Nacht.
In stille Nacht.
Zur ersten Wacht.
Zur ersten Wacht.
Zur ersten Wacht.
Zur TTS.
Zur ersten Wacht.
Ein Stimm.
Ein Stimm.
Begünnt zu klagen.
Begünnt zu klagen.
Der nächtige Wind.
Der nächtige Wind.
Hat süß.
Hat süß.
Und lind.
Und lind.
Zu mir den Klang.
Zu mir den Klang.
Getragen.
Getragen.
Von herbem Leid.
Von herbem Leid.
Und Traurigkeit.
Und Traurigkeit.
Ist mir das Herz.
Ist mir das Herz.
Zerflossen.
Zerflossen.
Die Blümelein.
Die Blümelein.
Mit Tränen rein.
Mit Tränen rein.
Hab ich sie all.
Hab ich sie all.
Begossen.
Begossen.
Stick to one for now. Let's give it a whirl. Do what you can. I know some of you don't speak German at all and may have never sung German before in your life. Have fun. Enjoy. You'll catch on real quick. So. In stille. Here we are. One and two.
Flossen, Gossen,
Fein,
They're gleaming. They want to weep with me. No bird song or joyous sounds can be heard in the air. The wild beasts also grieve with me in rocks and ravines.
Those romantic lyrics.
Wow. Yes, this is romantic era, heart on your sleeve, woe is me. Yeah, the poem actually dates from the 1600s, but the Germans love to take those at, you know, anything that they
it's
can
basically.
So,
it's that era's country music.
Oh, they loved it. It was like,
lost my bars. My car broke down.
Somebody shot my heart off.
My lover left me. Tears in my beer.
You know, if you play the verse.
Yes.
How do you sing German with a southern accent?
That's Schwäbisch. Yes.
One last time, now that you know what you're singing about.
Now everyone's smiling.
Just the first verse still. Here we are. One and two.
Sing that sort of flat or non-vibrato style is that they lose the dynamics. They're very still have lots of expressiveness.
Is this homophonic music?
No.
This is polyphonic music. Yeah, all the different lines doing there. There are a couple spots where we'll line up, but most of it is all over the place. So, good. Going on from there.
Thank you.
those guys would have won the 440 relay where you pass the baton.
Yeah,
if you listen at measure nine, or measure ten, the descending line is picked up by the altos and then by the tenors seamlessly. And then each one picks up the miserere on the next line. It's just, I mean, they're listening to each other and just picking up a little bit.
It sounded more like handing off solos.
Yeah.
Yeah. It's like,
kind of, this was only one person per part. It was five people.
They
so.
May want to consider taking a vow of silence.
It was pretty.
It was.
Birdie.
Good.
I thought when the bass came in that their dynamics kind of switched a little bit dramatically. It felt a little, wow, oh, the bass is changing.
Basses are always too loud.
It didn't happen.
Occupational hazard.
I really noticed that. Wow, that was a big difference. And the second entrance, the same thing.
Oh, yeah, especially that 23 or so where the basses come in, and the bass had so much more than somebody else. And so up till that point, I absolutely loved it. And then when the bass came in, I was like, just straighten it up. Not that I didn't like it, but it wasn't as bad.
It was kind of like showing up late.
Okay, last one then.
Just play it.
Well, this is a larger group, so this is now a group of 40, so this is a little bit more like what, we can't sound like five people because we're not five people.
No, we try to sound like 100 people.
So, it's a bad recording, I'm sorry, but...
Others were kind of really well done, kind of for that many voices, I felt like. I think that's one of the challenges when you have this many people is, like, to get that same sound that they got with five voices is, you know, you have to really be, like, finessing that and really careful every voice because we're used to, like, here we are, you know, and to, like, finesse those entrances and exits and handoffs like Gregor you know, alluded to is more challenging. And I thought they did a pretty good job with that. So it was different, not necessarily as like impressive as the five voice one, but considering the amount of people, I think it was pretty good.
Any other thoughts? Anything that inspires in you that when you're going to sing this, oh, I'm going to have to, whatever.
Practice restraint.
Practice restraint, that's a good way
to put it. Well, we all do in this group. I mean, we're not built.
We're not British.
And I think whatever.
But that's one of our challenges in this group. I always have to do this, practicing restraint.
For certain voices, yeah. And we have some voices that I feel like this is right up their alley,
yeah.
And it, you know, this is, they have the perfect voice for this. Other voices really have to come back. Yeah. So.
And I also feel like, too, sometimes we're good with our vowels for a point, and then you always have to remind us. So I think a song like this, we have to really be focused on keeping those vowels pure, because if we don't match up, like that's one of the reasons their sound is so beautiful, is their vowels were perfectly matched.
Yep. And they work hard to get it that way. That was BYU Singers, not one of their professional CDs, so that's why it's kind of a...
Yeah, the recording engineer was some stupid
sophomore late.
So...
I was the recording
engineer. But I love it. It is very smooth. Even though they have more people, and it's kind of a heavier sound just because you have that many more people, it is very smooth, very unified, and that's what we're after in here. So, now the issue is, who's going to sing what part? Because it's not going to be all sopranos on soprano, all altos on alto, and split my tenors in the two different parts. So
I'm not singing
off. No. So basses, you're all gonna be on bass. You're the easy ones. That's fine. What I'm looking at is Riley on tenor two, because it actually goes higher than the tenor one. Paul on tenor one, Allie and Debbie on tenor one, Michelle and Hope on tenor two. It's actually the higher of the two.
Oh, okay. I was like,
there are some notes that go way down, but just kind of mouth it or whatever. The whole time, yes.
And I'm on tenor one?
Tenor one, yes. It is written in that weird, you've got to sing an octave lower than what it's actually written, but, okay. So that leaves the rest of you altos on alto, and then McKenna, I'll pull you down to alto. And that leaves me five sopranos now. And McKenna, remind me that Julie's going to sing with you. She's going to go down to alto with you.
She will love that.
Yeah. So, all right, we're going to look at just the first 32 measures. You've heard the text a lot of times already, but those pure Latin vowels, a, e, e, o, u. That's all there is in Latin. We keep it very pure. A, nous, de, e, right? No, dei, dei. Qui, qui, we do the q, u, qui. Tolis peccata mundi, miserere nobis, and that's the whole first 34 measures, is all that. 32 measures, sorry. I do not have a reduction for this, so we'll just have to deal with it. So, yeah. Here we go. Now that you've heard it a couple times, hopefully it's a little bit familiar. Sort of, kind of. Try to stay loose. The hardest thing in pieces like this is that you tend to tense up. You hold back so much that everything gets tight. So stay loose, relax. We're just reading, so I'm not so worried about, you know, we're working notes at this point. So,
Thank you.
basement. How's that feel?
That's
is it going to work?
Because
okay.
Yeah,
Okay. Yeah, why don't you plan on doing that? Go ahead and jump down. We'll put you on tenor one for now. Is this the first time for anybody in singing this style of music? Yeah, I figured it was probably a first for Paul. Paul's in my ward. I am so grateful that he... We've wanted to drag him into this choir for a while, so we're glad that
he's here. Oh, Sally's here, too.
Sally!
Yay! Sally, don't put up with that. Don't take that.
Sally, we missed
you.
She'll actually be playing with us on one of the longer tunes, too. Yeah.
More flute?
So.
More flute?
More flute, I know.
More cowbell.
Let's do that much of it one last time, and then we'll switch to blue skies. Talk about switching genres here. How's it feel? Are you just exhausted when you finish singing a piece like this?
Max,
he's singing too.
Okay, I'm going to try this.
Okay,
right. I'll sit between you two. Could you sing?
Yeah.
Woo-hoo.
There we go. Hands up, ladies.
Okay.
Fabulous.
All right, here we go. From the beginning. Get out. Four. Find it all over the place,
But you're also going to find this. Don't make them all that. Sometimes it is just ti ti ta, and sometimes it's la la la. So.
Clapping rhythm.
We'll get it. So, nice thing is, this is just a regular soprano, alto, tenor, bass. There are a few times when it splits, but we'll deal with that later once we know.
How we pronounce this language?
Yeah, I know. Now, we're back to jazz. That doesn't mean you get to totally spread the sound and sing Dallas style. No. So,
run away. Golden
Oh!
Yes.